church. Let's come to God for the service today and call to worship. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs ye, faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and flesh sing for joy to the living God. Blessed are those who dwell in your house, ever singing your praise. We'll have the opening prayer.
Dearly beloved friends, may I wish you all a very blessed Sunday morning and welcome you all to this great time granted to us to worship our Lord. Let us begin our worship with a word of prayer. God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you with immense gratitude for bringing us together into your sanctuary. We are fully aware that you are in our midst as you have promised. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us once again to the time of Advent, a season of great anticipation and hope, especially in this situation of anxiety and fear created by this pandemic. Lord, fill our hearts with the assurance that nothing is impossible for you. Let us come to your holy presence, expecting your miraculous deliverance to us and to your children everywhere. Bless this worship service that we will experience your blessings in order that we would be a blessing to others. Be with us, guide us, and enlighten us that we may bring glory to your holy name, both now and forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
My Jesus, I love you. Thank you. Coma. Glory be to God, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Holy, 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 Lord God, of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Holy art thou, O God, holy art thou. O Lord, have mercy upon us. O Lord, accept our praise and worship and have mercy upon us. Glory to you, O Creator of all. O Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. May your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the time of trial, but deliver us from the evil one. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen. Prayer. O Lord God, enlighten us with the rays of your blissful and shining light. Cheer us this day with the joy of your resurrection from the dead. Make us joyful by your lordship. O God, our Messiah, who is the hope of our life and Savior of all our souls, strengthen us with the power of your grace. Amen. Psalm of Compassion. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. For I know my transgressions and my sin is ever before me. Purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation and uphold me with a willing spirit. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Prayer of confession 4. Almighty and eternal God, our Father, who is light to those in darkness, strength to those in weakness, and the only refuge to those who fall in sin, we thank you for this occasion you have given us to confess our manifold sins. We call upon your mercy, we're confident that you will accept those who truly confess their sins. Help us to offer our praise and thanksgiving with the assurance of the forgiveness of our sins. Hear us, we beseech you, in the name of the Lord, the Messiah. Amen. Absolution. May the Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all of them who with hearty repentance and true faith turn to him, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Marvelous petition. O merciful Lord, have compassion on us on our day of judgment. In our tenderness, forgive all mistakes. O compassionate one, we knock at your door during our miseries. O Lord, look with mercy on our humble petitions. O sympathetic Lord, knowing that you would open your door of blessings to repenting sinners, we come to you with a contrite heart. Heavenly Father, we are praying to you, accept our prayers and bless us. Let's praise the Almighty who promised, call and I will answer, seek and you shall find, and ask and you shall be given. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Magnificent. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. We praise you, O Triune God, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit, one in essence, in power, and in truth. Psalm 150. Praise the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in his mighty firmament. Praise him with trumpet sound, praise him with the flute and harp. Praise him with sounding cymbals, and praise him with loud clashing cymbals. Glory be to the Father, the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Praise of the angels. As the angels of the Most High, we the weak and frail praise you. Glory to God on high, at all times and in all seasons, and on earth, peace and unity and goodwill among human beings. Almighty Father, Heavenly King, Lord the Creator, we praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. O God, who is one with the Holy God and Son and the Holy Spirit, the Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Lord, who takes away the sins of the world, accept our prayers. O Lord, who sits at the right hand of God in glory, have mercy upon us and bless us. For you alone are holy, you alone are the Lord, for the glory of God the Father, you alone are Christ, the Holy Spirit of Most High. Amen. Prayer. O Lord Jesus Christ, shut not the door of your blessing against us. O Lord, your love has brought you down to us so that our death might be averted by your death. Now the Bible reading for first lesson, second lesson.
The first reading for this morning is taken from Genesis chapter 18, verses 1 to 15. Genesis chapter 18, verses 1 to 15. The Lord appeared to Abraham near the great trees of Mamre while he was sitting at the entrance to his tent in the heat of the day. Abraham looked up and saw three men standing nearby. When he saw them, he hurried from the entrance of his tent to meet them and bowed low to the ground. He said, "If I have found favor in your eyes, my Lord, do not pass your servant by. Let a little water be brought, and then you may all wash your feet and rest under this tree. Let me get you something to eat, so you can be refreshed and then go on your way, now that you have come to your servant." "Very well," they answered, "Do as you say." So Abraham hurried into the tent to Sarah. "Quick," he said, "get 3 seahs of fine flour and knead it and bake some bread." Then he ran to the herd and selected a choice tender calf and gave it to a servant who hurried to prepare it. He then brought some curds and milk, and the calf had been prepared, and set these before them. While they ate, he stood near them under a tree. "Where is your wife Sarah?" They asked him. "There in the tent," he said. Then the Lord said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah, your wife, will have a son." Now Sarah was listening at the entrance of the tent, which was behind him. Abraham and Sarah were already old and well advanced in years, and Sarah was past the age of childbearing. So Sarah laughed to herself as she thought, "After I am worn out and my master is old, will I now have this pleasure?" Then the Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Will I really have a child now that I am old?' Is anything too hard for the Lord? I will return to you at the appointed time next year, and Sarah will have a son." Sarah was afraid, so she lied and said, "I did not laugh." But he said, "Yes, you did." Here ends the first reading.
Second reading for this morning is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 3 verses 6 to 13. 1 Thessalonians chapter 3 verses 6 to 13. But Timothy has just come to us from you and has brought good news about your faith and love. He has told us that you always have pleasant memories of us and that you long to see us, just as we also long to see you. Therefore, brothers, in all our distress and persecution, we were encouraged about you because of your faith. For now, we really live, since you are standing firm in the Lord. How can we thank God enough for you? In return for all the joy we have in the presence of our God because of you. Verse 10, night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you again and supply what is lacking in your faith. Now may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus clear the way for us to come to you. May the Lord make your love increase and overflow for each other and for everyone else, just as ours does for you. May he strengthen your hearts so that you will be blameless and holy in the presence of our God and Father when our Lord Jesus comes with all his holy ones. Here is the reading.
Now we'll have the sixth creation.
Good morning, everyone. Our first song we will sing, "Worthy is the Lamb." kindly stand for our last song, God, You're So Good.
The prayer for the Holy Spirit for the fourth Sunday. We praise you, O Lord, for you have made us worthy of the gifts of the Holy Spirit which you have poured out on your disciples who waited in unity in accordance with your commandments. We confess our sinful nature by which we lose the gifts of grace we obtain. Renew in us the power of your Holy Spirit. Lord, make us loving. Make us cheerful and help us to make others cheerful. Make us peaceful. Make us patient and kind-hearted. make us true to ourselves, to others, and to you. May the spirit of service grow in us, adorn us with undying qualities of meekness and self-control. Grant us grace to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. Show discernment in everything and enjoy peace and happiness. Petition. We thank you, O God, our Father, the Lord of all things, who has brought us safely unto this hour. Keep us this day from sin and danger, and preserve us in righteousness. O Lord, our trust is in you alone. Let your loving care and tender mercy be upon us. O gracious Lord, teach us your statutes and lead us in them. Holy Lord, enlighten us with your light. Give to us this day all the good things we need, praise and glory and dominion are yours forever and ever. Amen. Go to the fourth Sunday Communion. Let us pray to the Lord for his grace and mercy. Make us worthy, O Lord, to offer to you continually praise and thanksgiving, glory, adoration, and unfading majesty. Your glorious resurrection overthrew those that despised you and comforted the disciples by your peace. You affirmed the apostles by your presence. You spread your doctrine throughout the world. To you belong praise, honor and majesty at this time of prayer and all the days of our lives forever and ever. Amen. Fourth Sunday, Sedra. O God, the mighty Word, you became man to make us partakers of your divine nature. O Creator, you came down as a creation but suffered no diminution. You descended as a Son of Man on your own will, but your divinity suffered no change. You became man for us, but your mighty power sustained no loss. You took our form, but your divine status did not shrink. You accepted death, but you remained ever the enemy to your sufferings. Your death conquered death, and by your resurrection you revealed eternal life. Therefore we pray you, O Lord, enlighten our wisdom to see the wonderful benefits from your resurrection. O Lord, give us grateful hearts and willing spirits to offer sacrifice of praise. Grant us grace to receive the radiating rays of your enlightening light. Enable us to enter your holy sanctuary through your glorious doors. As you are good and love humankind, we offer praise and glory to you and to the Father and to the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Fourth Sunday, Advent. Our Lord, who has offered the supreme sacrifice of yourself to redeem us from the death of sin and damnation, enlighten our conscience with the radiating beam of your gospel. Strengthen us to proclaim this good news to the people who have not known you. May the gifts of your Holy Spirit be showered upon us and upon them. Grant us your grace to believe in you, enjoy the benefits of your spiritual and temporal blessings, and to remain grateful to you forever and ever, forever. Amen. Fourth Sunday, Ma Ephraim's Prayer. Have mercy on us, O Lord, the Son of God, who by your glorious resurrection did make us free. O Lord, glory to you from your church, redeemed by your blood. Lord of festivals, praise to you from those who honor your festivals. Praise, glory, and adoration to you, the Father and Holy Spirit, forever. Praise and petition to the Most High. Blessed is the name of the Lord of the Most High. Holy and glorious Trinity, have mercy on us. You are holy and glorious forever. Our Lord, we praise you. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Hariburan, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the time of trial, but deliver us from the evil one. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen. Second part. O Lord, who was sacrificed on the heights of Calvary, and thereby did atone for the sins of the whole world, accept the prayers and supplications of your servants, who now await your abundant blessing, and cleanse our bodies and souls. Let love, peace, and unity reign among us. Make us worthy for a glorious resurrection, and for a place at your right hand forever, at your coming again. Amen. Psalm 63. O God, you are my God, early will I seek you. So I have looked upon you in the sanctuary, beholding your power and glory. So will I praise you as long as I live. I will lift up my hands and call on your name. For you have been my help, and in the shadow of your wings I sing for joy. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Litany, O Lord, the host of spirits and flaming fires praise you in the highest. Together with them we also sing praises to you. O Lord, we praise your humility, we glorify your divinity, and your resurrection from the dead. O Lord, we children of your faithful church praise you on earth because you have made us rejoice by your resurrection. The church and all her children praise you and glorify your resurrection because you have come and saved your church from the way of estrangement. The Lord be with you all. Intercessory prayer. O God of our fathers, establish our foundation on the rock of the faith of the prophets and apostles. Build us upon the true cornerstone, even Christ, who is the cornerstone of the Holy Church. Amen. O God, shed the mercies upon our bishops, priests, deacons, and the people who are entrusted to their care. Sprinkle thy dew of life upon them so that they may maintain the true doctrine for the glory of our Lord and Savior Christ. O Lord, we pray thee for all those who are in authority, statesmen, legislators, and all, especially for the king, the president, ministers, and all others who hold office in this country. Grant them wisdom, knowledge, broad-mindedness, the spirit of cooperation, and trust in God, and lead them under thy guidance to do good. The Nicene Creed. We believe in one true God, the Father Almighty, all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all the worlds, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, made of substance of the Father, by whom all things were made, both for us men and for salvation, came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, who was made man, and was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and died and was buried. The third day he rose again by his own will, and ascended into heaven, and sits on the right hand of God the Father, and he shall come again in glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, spoke by the prophets and apostles. We believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the new life of the world to come. Amen. message and then
God Almighty. Praise be to thee, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise be to thee, Lord God Almighty. We thank thee, Lord God, for all thy blessings, thy grace, and thy mercies, Lord, that we come today, Lord God, and surrender into thy hands, Lord God, our offerings of praises and glory and thanksgiving, Lord God, as we you accept this thanksgiving of ours, Lord God. We ask that it be used for the glory of thy kingdom. We ask all these things in the heavenly name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Morning, church, and may the peace of Christ be with you. The announcements for today. To members of the Bayou Padane area who led in the service today, we thank you for this blessed morning. Next Sunday, 5 December, we will be celebrating Holy Communion service in Malayalam. The service, which will begin at 9:30 in the morning, will be celebrated by Reverend Mathew K. Punos. Year-end programs. The details of services scheduled for December will be sent via WhatsApp by Tuesday. Please be informed that the programs are subject to change if changes are made to the current SOP for churches. If there are new announcements from the authorities, we will inform of the changes via WhatsApp. Contribution towards the funds of the parish. You are reminded of your financial obligation towards the funds of the parish. During the meeting of the parish committee held on Sunday, 14 November, it was informed that we are in need of about 300,000 ringgit to run the expenses of the parish for a year. To date, we have only collected about 140,000, which is less than 50% of the required amount. To members who have been blessed, we appeal for your generous contribution. In this way, it will be helpful to members who have been going through difficult times due to the pandemic. Voters list of the parish. Achan has approved the request for the list to be updated. The current voters list of the parish will be sent together with the bulletin. Thereafter, we will be removing all the names of members who have left us and also including new eligible members. If you are 18 years and above, on or before 1st January 2021, you can be included in the voters list. Members who are now self-employed are requested to apply for a separate membership number. Please contact the secretary for inclusion of new names and also for a separate membership number. The first copy of the new voters list will then be placed on the notice board for a period of 2 weeks. This will enable members to view and request for changes to be made. Achan will then scrutinize the request before the final list endorsed by Achan is placed on the notice board. Our vicar, Very Reverend K.S. Mathew, has requested for all other matters of the parish, especially with regards to a general body meeting, be discussed by after Achan has arrived. All these announcements will be posted in the December bulletin and it will be sent by Tuesday. If you need a hard copy of the bulletin, please contact me. And the message for this morning will be brought to us by our vicar, Very Reverend K.S. Mathew. It will be screened on the screens above. After the message, as you leave, please adhere to all SOPs. Thank you.
For our meditation this morning, I have chosen that text which was the gospel portion fixed for this Sunday. That is Luke chapter 1, verses 39 to 56. It is a lengthy passage rather, but I would prefer to read it throughout. May I read it out for you? Luke's Gospel, chapter 1, verses 39 to 56. Soon afterwards, Mary got ready and hurried off to a town in the hill country of Judea. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby moved within her. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and said in a loud voice, "You are the most blessed of all women, and blessed is the child you will bear. Why should this great thing happen to me that my Lord's mother comes to visit me? For as soon as I heard your greeting, the baby within me jumped with gladness. How happy you are to believe that the Lord's message to you will come true." Mary said, "My heart praises the Lord. My soul is glad because of God my Savior, for he has remembered me, his lowly servant. From now on, all people will call me happy because of the great things the mighty God has done for me. His name is holy. From one generation to another, he shows mercy to those who honor him. He has stretched out his mighty arm and scattered the proud with all their plans. He has brought down mighty kings from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away with empty hands. He has kept the promise he made to our ancestors and has come to the help of his servant Israel. He has remembered to show mercy to Abraham and to all his descendants forever." Mary stayed about 3 months with Elizabeth and then went back home. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for your word. We thank you that your word reveals to us your eternal truths and your plan of salvation. May we be ready and faithful to accept the challenges that your word poses before us and respond in obedience and surrender. Bless us all and bless the hearing of your word spoken by your servant, and bless your children who listen to it. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. One of the most painful consequences of the COVID pandemic is that we are all forced to maintain social distance, social isolation. People were and still are afraid to meet each other. How sad and tragic it is that even the dearest relatives of the deceased are not able to see and bid farewell to their dear ones for the last time on earth. As humans, we need the company of each other so much, especially in times of crisis, sorrow, pain, and anxiety. The visitation by a loved one on such an occasion makes a world of difference, both to the visitor and the visited. Our gospel text read to us today tells of the encounter between two women with much similarities, although they belong to different age groups. In traditional liturgies, this episode is known as the Visitation. Luke's Gospel opens with two separate but parallel announcements. They are called Annunciations, by Angel Gabriel to one to Zechariah, the childless priest, the father-to-be of John the Baptist, the forerunner of Christ, and the other to Virgin Mary. These were the portions read out to us during worship service last two Sundays as gospel passages. At the end of the Annunciation to Mary, the angel tells her that her old and barren cousin Elizabeth was expecting a child as a miraculous blessing from God. Elizabeth, who is on the sixth month of her pregnancy, is living alone and aloof in her house in the hill country of Judea. Mary, the young virgin, blessed and chosen to be the mother of the Savior, goes in haste to meet her cousin Elizabeth, primarily to see in person that the angelic message of Elizabeth's pregnancy is true. The two separate storylines merge when Mary visits Elizabeth. Her journey is an expression of faith, obedience, and also an indication of joy and wonder. There is no reason to think that Mary's visit was to check out the veracity of the angelic statement about Elizabeth, because she had already accepted Gabriel's words as true. But by this visit, she becomes reassured of the angelic creed of all creeds, that with God, nothing will be impossible. Here we see two very ordinary women being made extraordinary by divine intervention in their lives, as they become instruments of God's redemptive work. They become very extraordinary mothers, models of genuine friendship, and visionaries of eternal and universal significance. Let us briefly meditate on some insights provided by this incident of the visitation in Luke's Gospel. Firstly, it was a friendship and fellowship that empowered both of them. Both were stressed and anxious. Mary's journey was strenuous yet fruitful. Elizabeth was lonely and was in hiding. Mary also had so many forebodings and fears in her heart. At the same time, both of them were excited as they were expecting things which were too good to be true to happen in their lives. Due to several obvious reasons, both of them had many things to keep a secret as well. For the very same reason, they could understand each other well and empathize with each other. It seems fitting that they share the gospel news within themselves and are strengthened by the working of the Holy Spirit in their lives. They share the good news fully conscious of its serious implications. Therefore, the encounter transforms both of them and it empowers them to face life with confidence, assurance, and hope. They thus become models of genuine friendship and sharing, which is needed most in our day when people, many of them, are living in loneliness and forsakenness. Do our relationships express genuine experience of sharing, caring, and empathizing to empower us? That is a very important question to be asked today. But this empowerment is accomplished not merely by human effort. It was really an act of faith because they saw the hand of God behind them. We should do well to observe that the Holy Spirit is at work throughout the episode. The working of the Holy Spirit shifts them from being mere victims to effective instruments in fulfilling the great purpose of God in the world. They assume a state of blessedness in the hope of this fulfillment, although their journey of life was going to be beset with suffering, agony, and humiliation. Their submission to the divine will and obedience made them agents of sharing hope and light to the whole world. They come to understand that they are blessed by God to be a blessing to so many others. Our empowerment should happen through prayer and the power of the Holy Spirit. Our blessings should become real as we become a great blessing to others. That is the meaning of blessing according to our faith. We are not having private blessings. We are blessed to be a blessing to so many others. Secondly, this encounter leads them to rejoice in the Holy Spirit. Joy is a recurring theme in the Gospel of Luke from beginning to end, and particularly in the opening chapters. The child rejoices in the Spirit in his mother's womb. Both Elizabeth and Mary rejoice. The tension, anxiety, and fear in their hearts are taken away, and they rejoice in the Holy Spirit. Mary's visit made Elizabeth joyous, and her voice makes even the unborn child rejoice. Mary, in turn, rejoices by recognizing divine blessedness in Elizabeth's words. They contain news of a child who grants joy to the entire world. What mother has not waited for the first stirrings of a child or felt the goodness of God's blessings in the fullness of her womb? The joy of Mary and Elizabeth is the joy of all who look forward with wonder and thankfulness to the birth of a child. The journey of this wonder with God's saving work invites us to consider how the experiences of expectancy teaches us the ways of God's gracious work in the human experience. Every birth, therefore, can be a sign of salvation, of finding favor, of being blessed, of living with promise, and of realizing its fulfillment. Both Mary and Elizabeth are led to an experience of ecstasy as a result of the working of the Holy Spirit, because joy is the fruit of the Spirit, and they both burst forth into a song of joy, praise, prophecy, and new vision. Thirdly, this encounter leads them to a greater vision of the Savior God and His salvation. The encounter culminates in ecstatic and inspired songs from both of them. They are songs of divine revelation and revolution. Mary's song especially is known as the Magnificat, a name coming from the opening word in its Latin translation. The early church saw the Magnificat as an expression of the kind of salvation wrought through Jesus Christ. We regularly recite the Magnificat in our liturgy, but unfortunately most of us fail to understand its implications. This song presents Mary in a different light altogether. Saint Mary is turned into an object of worship and adoration today. Perhaps the easiest way to nullify the challenge posed by a saint's life and message. She is used today for receiving favors mainly in terms of material blessings. But this song brings out a totally different person who tells us of the great revolution that God is going to bring about in the world. This revolution is moral, social, economic, political, and spiritual. And this revolution is brought about by the gospel of Christ and his gospel. What God has done for Mary anticipates and models what God will do for the poor, the powerless, and the oppressed of the world everywhere. There's a universal significance. She also sings of a God who brings down the mighty, the proud, and the exploiter. Therefore, we see that the Annunciation is followed by a denunciation. There is Annunciation as well as denunciation here. We may do well to see that this has been happening in the world, in world history, during the past centuries, through the dynamic impact of the gospel of Christ in human affairs. The song expresses in sharpest focus what has been called a classical statement of God's activity. Mary sings of a God who is not neutral, but who brings down the mighty and exalts those of low degree, who fills the hungry and sends the rich empty away. God is not neutral. He is taking sides, actually. Of course, he wills the redemption of all people, ultimately. It talks of a reversal happening and is going to happen in the world. Here we also have a characteristic of the final judgment of God, in which there is a complete reversal of fortunes. These things are presented in past tense to indicate that they are timelessly true, and also to make us certain that this will happen. There's an element of certainty and assurance. God's choice of Mary itself provides a telling evidence to this truth. Mary's visionary song poses before us certain important challenges. Are we concerned about the gross and sinful disparities that exist in the world today? Between the rich and the poor, between the powerful and the weak, between the privileged and the marginalized? Are we keenly aware of the lack of distributive justice with regard to the earth's resources today? For example, a recent economic survey reports that during the pandemic time so far, the number and assets of multi-billionaires have increased exponentially, and the number of people living in abject poverty has also gone up alarmingly in the world. That is very sad. As followers of Christ and his gospel, does this scenario disturb us deeply, or are we blissfully oblivious of these harsh realities around us? Mary's song and the entire biblical message categorically makes it clear that God is with the victims always, not with the victimization. The crucial question is whether we are with our God. Dear friends, in the visitation of Mary to Elizabeth and their coming together, we see a fellowship which surpasses all barriers and hurdles, which was mutually empowering and joyous. It was grounded on the faith in a God who accomplishes the impossible in and through ordinary lives. It provides partnership and vision regarding the saving plan of God to both of them. We are challenged to foster such fellowship in these times of aloofness and loneliness. They also present before us the lesson that mothers are called to be models, molders, mediators, motivators, and missionaries. Most importantly, it challenges us to be partners with a God who endeavors to bring about a reversal of the sad state of the world as we see it today. Let us be empowered to rejoice and participate in this great work of redemption wrought by God in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Uttama. O Lord our God, glory to you forever. Glory to you, glory to you. O Lord Christ, by your compassion and infinite grace, hear our prayers and accept our service. O Lord God, come for our help and cleanse us. O Lord, may our service be agreeable to you, our worship pleasing, our petitions acceptable, and our prayers worthy of your acceptance. O Lord God, may your blessings, mercies, and help and all your divine gifts come on us who are weak and upon our weak human race and dwell among us forever. Amen. Benediction. You are blessed by the Lord who created heaven and earth. May the Lord bless and sanctify all of you who have attended this divine service with us. May the God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit hear and accept our weak and inadequate prayers before his throne of grace. Amen. Mm-hmm.